To all Dhamma brothers and sisters throughout the world, I would like to tell you that in our life there are many difficulties, physical difficulties, mental difficulties, not being able to fulfill your wishes and so on. So for especially nowadays, due to the pandemic, the whole world is facing so much suffering and so much problems. So at this time, of course, we have to be very careful, try to do washing and wearing masks and giving away from busy places and so on. But on top of that, then to seek the blessings of the triple gem, and especially the Ayatara. Ayatara is the mother of all the Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, Shavakas and Pratyeka Buddhas in human form. And she is looking after the sentient beings day and night. And so, and she has special manifestations to look after the different problems, such as like fire, the water, the dangerous animals, and so on. All sentient beings, especially those who are in trouble, those who have problems, therefore to look after them, Ayatara is great. And so therefore it is very important to recite her mantra, Om Tare Tu Tare Ture Soha, and also her prayers, the short prayers, and that we are accumulating. And if this we do this, then it will certainly pacify all the problems that you are facing and will fulfill all your wishes. There is a story a long time ago, the Dangichi Mahatma Sangbopar from Sakya went to China, and he was not an official queen's son, though he was a Kuan lineage and he was a genuine Kuan lineage. But he's not an official queen's son. So therefore, he didn't get the recognition from the emperor, and he was sent far away, some other countries. And there he can face difficulties because nobody recognized him as a Kuan lineage. And so he was kind of in the kind of lost. So he prayed to the Ayatara. And then one day the Ayatara appeared in person and put her hand on his head and said, if you want a child, you will be get a child. If you want a wealth, you will get wealth. And all your wishes will be granted, and all your obstacles will be pacified. And then at that moment, the princess from Sakya, the Jituma, went to China, and she passed away on the way, and her bones became relics and offered to the emperor. And so the emperor put her bones on his head and cried that there's no difference between male or female, as long as it's my guru's lineage, hereditary lineage, it is a great, but now we don't have the hereditary lineage. And then the ministers told him that actually there is a one son. He is a genuine queen lineage, but because he was not the official queen's son, we did not recognize him and he was sent away. And so then he changed his mind, and then he said, if that is the case, we must invite him. You must invite the send the messengers and invite him and enthrone him in the palace with a great ceremony and offer a lot of offerings and give a very grand reception. And then he said to him that now the hereditary lineage is very, very important. And so he offered his own sister, the emperor's sister, to the Tanishima Samapa to marry. And then they both went back to Sakya and they had a son. And at the present, the current lineage is actually from his son and so on that came down until now. So all his wishes were fulfilled by the blessings of the Ayadhara. So we pray to her, especially in these very difficult times, that it is very, very important and to recite the mantra and to recite the prayers to accumulate as many as possible. This will help not only individuals but the whole world will have a great effect. So I appeal everybody to generate a great devotion to the Ayadhara and recite mantras and prayers, and this will be a great help to individuals as well as the whole area, the whole world. And so may the blessings of the Ayadhara be with you now and always. Om Dare Tu Dare Ture Soha, Om Dare Tu Dare Ture Soha, Om Dare Tu Dare Ture Soha.